Good morning and happy Friday, y'all. My hair has never looked better for this time of day. I'm getting ready for some meetings. I've been up for a little bit, but I didn't sleep well last night. But it is 7 o'clock and I have a meeting at 7:30, so getting ready. I have lots of meetings today, but it's been an okay week. That's what I'll say. It's been an okay week. Ooh, let's get some coffee. And I just finished a really long week with some really tough moments. I slept an hour to an hour and a half yesterday. There's been anxious moments, great moments, tiring moments, frustrating moments, all the moments. They've just all been there. But we made it through. We made it through. We can do hard things. We have survived 100% of our toughest days thus far. That's a good track record. Steven is making dinner tonight because he knows it's been a lot this week. So I'm not quite sure what he's making, but he saw it on Rachel Ray. There seems to be some pumpkin puree, some sort of peppers, and then some really big pasta. So he is making that tonight. This also just came in the mail from Amazon. Literally, I just unpacked it and fluffed it a little bit. It's a pre-lit Christmas swag for your mailbox. So you like wrap it around. I'll tell you, it was like $28, maybe $30. It looks really nice for being on the mailbox. I am gonna go put this on a little bit once the outside lights turn on. Also, got a package at my P.O. box from Burst. We're gonna open that. Those lights haven't kicked on yet. Let's go ahead and open this now. All right, so Burst is an amazing, amazing electronic toothbrush. I literally don't know what was sent. So they sent whitening strips. I love their whitening strips. Oh my gosh, I'm losing my mind right now. I got sent. And this is why I have another brush, because I didn't have a good travel case for mine. I got sent the rose gold Burst brush. It's so pretty. I'm gonna leave all the information linked below. This would be a great, great Christmas gift. The brushes are really, really nice. I am losing it. Here's the thing. It has a deep cleaning rubber piece inside the bristles, which is amazing. It really does clean your teeth. It does clean and polishing. It has a quad pacer. So every 30 seconds, your toothbrush pauses for a half second to remind you it's time to switch the position. It's just such a good toothbrush. It also has a full 2-minute timer, but I've been taking a different toothbrush to work with me because I didn't have a good case, but this one has a case. Oh, I'm pumped about this.
Steven is making dinner. I am actually, you guys are always asking to like let him film more, so I'm literally going to hand the vlogging camera over to him and let him talk you through dinner. He saw it on Rachel Ray today and he's gonna give it a whirl. So I'm handing over the camera and I'll see you guys in a little bit.
Okay, so for today's dinner, we're making a Rachel Ray recipe. Stop laughing.
Recipe? You said that because of Rachel Ray.
No. Recipe. We're not making a Rachel Ray recipe, we're making a Rachel Ray recipe. So, this morning I had the day off because I had to go to the dentist and now I have to have my wisdom tooth pulled. But before I went, I watched Rachel Ray in the morning and got inspired. So I'm doing one of her dishes that she had on today. It's a pumpkin puree, vodka, kale, pasta dish. So as you can see, I have all the ingredients here and the skillet's warming up. And I guess I should put water in there to make the pasta boil. But I'm gonna take you through it. So we'll start there and put the butter in. Oops, it's too hot.
So go back.
The fire department has been here and left. Bubba's barked at them. But I think, stop. So I think that we are making progress here. We have the pumpkin vodka sauce, and then we are boiling the noodles. Rachel Ray said that they're supposed to be shells, but I couldn't find them at Wegmans, our grocery store. I don't know where they keep them, so I had to get this big, I guess it's like a rotini or rigatoni pasta. They had a name for it, but I forgot. So we're waiting for this to finish, and then we'll put it al dente into there, mix it up a little, and we should be done. So sorry I did not film all my steps. I was a little bit flustered. As Christopher knows, in the kitchen, I can be a little bit frazzled if things don't go my way, but I think hopefully it will be good now that everything is taken care of. Bubba's is obsessed with pastas and carbs of all sorts. So, as you can see, he's prowling around, waiting for the pasta to finish. I think about 3 more minutes. So while we are waiting for the pasta to finish, I put a cup of vodka in here along with a can of pumpkin puree, some nutmeg, the onions and garlic, some spicy hot pepper seasoning, or some pepper flakes, and of course the kale and cream. So that's what's going into the sauce, and then I'm going to add a cup of water to the sauce after this gets done. And look who's here. So I've added the pasta to the sauce over here, and now she says sprinkle in the cheese. At least that can all fall out. Might be too much, but we'll make it work. You can always put it on top. So I think this is done. It actually does look sort of like macaroni and cheese. It has the same color, although it's pumpkin and vodka sauce with this big pasta. And then, so I think we are ready to go. Right?
Dinner was delicious. Stephen did such a good job. I'm really proud of him. Besides a visit from the fire company, everything was wonderful. He recovered and was resilient. And he made a really good dinner, and I'm so grateful. We're just watching The Crown tonight and just going to relax because it's been a week. So I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Alexa, turn on tree. Since the last time I talked to you, I told you I was waiting for one last ornament for this tree, which is, I think, all of our favorite tree this year. Actually, both are the best two trees I've done. But the ornaments I was waiting for are these deer. Look at these. Aren't they beautiful? They are really heavy, but like, look at them. They're from Grandin Road. They come in sets of 3. I have 9 of them, and they're all tucked into different spots in the tree. It was the final ornament I was looking for. So This tree is officially all done. So my friend Maggie at Home on the Ridge, she shared something on her Instagram that she did that I thought was really cool. We're gonna play with it because I feel like I'm missing color here in the table, like between the chargers and the runner, everything is so white and silver. But the tree is so colorful that I feel like I need to change that up. So we're gonna play with some ideas. What Maggie did, and like I said, I'm gonna leave her linked below. She put a piece of wrapping paper under her table runner. So now I'm just looking at both of these. I think for me, this one's too busy, but I really do like the way the green looks. We're gonna give it a try and see how it ends up. I think it could look really cool. I'll fold the corners really crisply. We're gonna see if we can do this. We discuss how elevated this looks. I did change out for a different wreath that I had downstairs. This one just has like a little bit more sheen. Like, I don't know, I just really like it. I also think with the way the tree has shaped up, it just looks a little bit better. This looks perfect. What a cool trick to just lift everything. This table just needed a little bit more color to ground itself, and this is absolutely perfect. It's stunning. I'm so happy with it. This is another reason why I love decorating early, because you have time to play with new things, try new things, and change things up if you want to. I love it. What a simple trick to add some layering, and it's just beautiful. Also, if I was entertaining this year, what I would do is get like a gold paint pen and scroll everyone's name like in a crescent shape around the edge of their plate on the wrapping paper. This is so cool, and it's such a cheap way. Like that neutral table runner, you can amp up for any holiday. It's really a cool idea. So I just took down the flocked garland. I've been trying to like force myself to like it, and I knew I didn't like it with this year's theme. The flocking is just not right for this year. And like, I was forcing myself to use it because I spent a lot of money on that garland, and I do really like it, but like, it was just taking away from everything else. So I think I'm gonna put like a very simple magnolia swag over that door that's green, and then the back of the leaves are that beautiful gold color. But I'm much happier with this look, because like, I just want that tree to shine. And I feel like, I don't know, I just didn't love it. And that's the thing, if you don't love it, don't keep it. I had this really pretty magnolia garland. Look how cool that, I love the way it's draping, but for me, it feels like it goes with our decor more, because like everything is like rich pine, and like there's no flocking anywhere, so that feels really good. Yes. Oh, it looks so good in here. Already getting so much done today. So we did the dining room table, we've ran some errands, and I'm out here, and I picked this up from Michael's this week. I've wanted a real, like, it doesn't look as big as it is on camera, but it's actually quite large. I've wanted a big statement deer piece. This guy was $100, but he was 40% off, which brought him down to like 60 something. And then I had a $40 voucher. I got him for 20 bucks. So I love him, but I want him to be all matte black. So I went and picked up some spray paint. I'm gonna paint him all matte black. That way he matches my Pottery Barn lanterns on my sofa table. Okay, he is completely coated. Right now he looks a little glossy. He's actually going to be a matte black when done. So when he dries down, he'll be completely matte. But I really, really like him.
It's perfect.
Steven is just like every weekend doing mock trials. He's judging them. But I just brought in the deer now that he is painted black. And I really love it. It's exactly how I needed it to be perfect. Because I really wanted it to connect with the black lanterns. All of our lights around the house are black with the dark fireplace. And then also next year, I'm doing a really neutral theme. So he'll tie in perfectly. And if I ever want to paint him a different color, I can. But I'm really happy with that. And then starting to get some ideas together for the fire, not the fireplace, my banister. I have a lot of things happening for that. Not a lot of things, but some really good ideas. But I picked up these really pretty navy, almost black stockings. So I always thought I could use those next year. And then I like to fill my stockings with stuff. So for $5 a piece, I thought these were really, really beautiful. This combination of the green and white magnolias with maybe these sticks in them as well. And then some live pine. I really liked it. And then this khaki golden color and the neutral will also work next year. So thought that was a good steal. Those will happen at some point. But you all keep asking about the stairs, and I have a plan for the stairs. I'm just waiting for everything to come in. It's going to be simple, but I think it will be beautiful. So, stuff happening there. Let me talk you through the outside this year and try to do it without Bubba's barking. It's actually quite cold. So, we have three, I forget what they are, but it's about 30 feet of garland. I think they're 10-foot pieces a piece. They might be 12, I don't know. But we have them, they hang completely to the ground. And then this is what I've done. I've done a really long red bow. I made that bow myself. It's so easy. I'm gonna cut away now to show you how to make it. I don't know if any of you are like me, but I cannot make bows. It's just not something I can do. However, I am gonna show you an easy way that I'm able to do it, because I have a wreath that I need to put a bow on. This is not gonna be fancy, but for all of us who are not bow making people, if I can do this bow, you can do this bow. So, all I have right now is I have my ribbon. I'm going pretty simple outside on the front porch. As you know, I have a yellow door, and I thought the blue velvet ribbon that I bought is so dark, it almost reads black in some light. So that's what I'm gonna go with. So I have a really long piece, and then a shorter piece. It just depends on how big you want your bow to be. So I'm gonna start finding my centers and just like folding it over. And then I'm gonna take this one and do the same thing. Try to find the closest center that I can. I will puff this up once it's done. But if I lay that on top, I have like a layered effect. You could do multiple layers if you wanted to. Now, what I'm going to do really quickly is I'm gonna flip these each over, and I'm just gonna add a bead of glue and make sure that loop is actually closed off. So now I'm gonna really focus on getting these stacked on top of each other neatly and very evenly. This one needs to go a little bit more this way. And then I'm gonna fold this over so I can find my true center or close to it. And then all I'm going to do is I'm gonna start gathering I'm gonna gather it up like this, and it doesn't look like much. And then I'm gonna hurry up and I'm gonna get a piece of wire. I'm gonna move over so it stays in the center. And I'm going to try my best to make this wire really, really tight. And then I'm just gonna pull that wire out to the sides, because I'll need that to also attach to the wreath eventually. Take another piece of my ribbon and I cut it. And now I'm gonna put a string of glue down one side. And all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make like a seam and fold a part of that over. Take glue down this other side. I'm gonna fold that piece over. So that I get just a nice, neat little tail. And then it probably is not gonna need to be this long. But I'm gonna center that. Put some glue on the back of my bow here. And I'm just gonna glue that piece there. And I'm going to put a little bit more hot glue. Glue this other one down. So that's what we have so far. I wish my lighting was a little bit better. So that's what we have so far. Let me move you up just a hair. So this is what we have so far. And now you'll see once we puff all these up, you could alternate your ribbons and do different ribbons. I mean, this is the only way that I have ever found that I make a bow that looks somewhat decent. Then I want really long tails. So I have a really long piece of ribbon cut. I want one tail to be slightly longer than the other. So I'm gonna take it, let me see if I can show you. And I'm just gonna fold, kind of gather it up so that it forms the two tails. And then I am gonna take a piece of wire and all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bunch that up together just to make sure it stays like that. I know that this is not fancy, but I'm telling you, for me, this is a really good bow. I'm not gonna cut my tails until I get it situated on my wreath, but I think it's gonna be really, really pretty. And then I literally saved a bunch of Amazon boxes and old jar candles that I had to weigh them down, and I simply wrapped them with some black and white paper, added red bows to them, just tied them off. I spray painted that fella black, bought these three new lanterns. We needed new lanterns out here, ours were in rough shape. So three new lanterns, and then I had these pine trees already. The pots were originally white marble. I just gave them a coat of black spray paint. You guys always know I always layer my rugs, so this is the same rug as always, and I love how that pattern plays with the plaid. Found this little mat at Target. It ended up perfect. And then what I did love is that on this wreath, I made the tails really long, and I love the red with the yellow. I was really nervous about how I would like my door this year, and I really love it. We'll have to come out in the evening so you guys can see it then. I'm actually thinking about, while Steven is working so much, of hopping down to the local greenhouse just to see what they have. Because I would love to maybe fill this spot with poinsettias. I know a lot of you are saying poinsettias are poisonous to dogs, which I totally get. And I think you know your pets and if your pets get into things. I have had poinsettias every year all over our house. Bubba's doesn't bother anything. Since the day we got him, he has never touched, Steve and I just talked about this. He has never touched, destroyed, chewed, eaten anything but food. He's like literally the perfect dog. He has a little bit of an attitude and some sass and some good side eye, but as far as bothering things in our home, he doesn't. So if my in-laws bring their dog, definitely we'll put them up, but I know with Bubba's, they're perfectly safe. He will probably never even walk over to them. So just wanna let you guys know that if I put poinsettias out, you do not have to worry about Bubba's. They've been in our house for the 13 years we've had him. He will never bother them. Friends, I am back from the greenhouse. I bought this really big poinsettia and I got a really pretty pot that matches that. Although the poinsettia is so big you can't see. I'm thinking I might need to add another one in there, but I'm not sure. The other thing I purchased to just jazz up a couple spaces around the house is I bought some live greens. I have a really good relationship with my greenhouse. I go there all the time. It's the only one I go to. They know me there. And actually some people that I really enjoy were there today. And they let me know to not, normally I would soak these in the bathtub for about 24 hours. And they said they had just soaked them, so they're good to go. And while we were there, we also treated them with anti-wilting spray. I'm all out of the kind I use here, but I'll leave it linked below. And I actually just need to order some. So let me show you what I picked up. I picked up this port cedar bunch. I actually bought two of those because I have an idea of what I want to do with those. And then to weave in to break up that cedar, I bought some beautiful boxwood stems and also some Fraser fir stems. What I'm envisioning is, A, I want to definitely get some greens on this table in some way. And then I also think it could be really nice to embed some greenery coming up and around this table. I am just going to play and see what happens. So the first thing I'm playing with is this idea of like kind of draping this around. I do want to bring a couple of the cedar pieces along this side too to almost create a swag. I'm thinking that some of these I don't know. Let me see if I can get one more on there if I like it more. Because I don't. Yes, I kind of love that. Oh, it's really stunning. I'll give it a spritz of water eventually. I think before I go on with the boxwood, because it's the most gentle and light of the bunch, I'm gonna grab some Fraser fir and just tuck some in. I'm playing, I laid my cedar first and got it like swagged around. I brought it up a little over the candle holders just because I thought it was a beautiful touch. Brought it around and then layered in my Fraser fir. And then lastly, went in with like some boxwood to give it some height in spots. It's stunning. And then every other day, I'll spray it with water. But like this was literally like $10, $12. So once it dries out and looks droopy, I'll go buy new and rearrange it. Over here, I'm still playing a little bit. I had some leftover cedar. So I wanted to just kind of like cascade it around here, get some pieces hanging off. And I have started going and tucking in some of the pine. So I'm just gonna fill in around. And then I still have a bunch of boxwood to fill in with. I used up all of my clippings and it looks really beautiful. All my extra fir clippings, I just threw in my fruit bowl because it just adds like a beautiful touch to it. But I think it looks really, really beautiful. It's exactly like what I needed to just finish off the space. I'm really happy with it. Actually realized that a bunch of you have asked me how I styled those houses from the dollar store, and I realized I never actually showed all of you except on Instagram. So go follow me on Instagram if you're not. We do lives. I answer every single DM I get. It's a great way to connect, but this is how I styled them. There's a garland behind them. It lights up at 5 o'clock, but dollar bin at Target, and it looks so expensive. Good morning, everybody, and happy Sunday morning. It is around 8-ish. I just finished coffee with my friend Rebecca. We do it every other Sunday via FaceTime. I love her so much. And yeah, so we had coffee together for like over an hour, just chatted about life and our week, and yeah, it was lovely, lovely, lovely. Steven is up, he's eating breakfast. Bubby is up. What's up here? Oh yes, get all the people. We're gonna probably watch Good Morning America, watch a little news, have some coffee. Right? What? Do you want some bread? What?
So, I have to tell you a funny story. Steven, a couple nights ago, bought me a bottle of Prosecco and put it in the freezer to chill, and we forgot about it, and it exploded in our freezer. So I just, like, re-cleaned out the freezer. So I know that's the content you guys sign up for. The way I keep my freezer organized is I have bins. So this is all vegetables. That's all that stays in that section. And then this bottom section is proteins. And then like some like one-off weird things, like I have some falafel from Trader Joe's and some frozen gnocchi. And then I also have my freezer in my garage that we keep stocked. And then once I like cleaned out the freezer, I was like, well, I want to make sure the pantry's all organized for Thanksgiving. So I went through and checked all the expiration dates on everything. It's going to sound weird, but I dusted off the tops of the cans just so they were clean. And just made sure everything in here was stocked and good to go. I double checked my Thanksgiving list. I also ordered us a pie to pick up on Wednesday from a small local dairy and bakery. So that's done. And then I'm just waiting now to get in touch with Williams-Sonoma to go pick up my curbside order. And yeah, that's basically what a Sunday looks like.
Hi, friends, I am back from Williams-Sonoma. I did the curbside pickup. If you don't have a Williams-Sonoma, you can buy all of this online and probably find a promo code or something. However, the one thing I wanted to get was their turkey gravy starter for Thanksgiving. And she said they're all sold out, but I have one coming on Tuesday that I'll be able to pick up. But I'll show you what I grabbed. Some of this is like stocking up for like Vlogmas and Christmas season. So I don't know if you've ever had their vanilla marshmallows, but they're the best. I also bought some really cute snowmen marshmallows as well. And then for Thanksgiving breakfast, I'm either gonna do the wild blueberry pancakes and waffles or just the regular Belgium waffle mix. And then I got a tin of double dark hot chocolate. And then I also got a tin of the classic hot chocolate as well. And then I've been wanting to try this because the Barefoot Contessa had it. And it is the hand-harvested sea salt from France. And then lastly, I got us a good jar of maple syrup for our waffles on Thanksgiving and throughout the winter. So that is my little Williams-Sonoma haul minus the turkey gravy starter. If you can't make gravy, I've heard rave reviews around the Williams-Sonoma starter.
All right, friends, it is about 3 o'clock on Sunday, and I've edited part of the vlog while Steven was taking a nap, and it's like a half hour long. So I'm just going to end it here because there's already so much, but I will end it like I end all of them. Well, before I do that, I am going to be vlogging Thanksgiving, and then before you know it, Vlogmas is happening. Tune in this week because not only will I have a vlog from Thanksgiving, but the day after Thanksgiving, I will have a Vlogmas intro video where all the things get shared with you, from the advent calendar to the merch to the Spotify playlist, and also some of the things that are happening during Vlogmas this year. I'm so excited, but I'll end this like I end all of them. Take care of yourself, take care of others, and be kind. Kindness is free. Give it to everyone. Until next time, my friends. Bye-bye.